I was impressed by the power of the engine, by that roaring sound, and by the fact that it took me to the sky. So my name is Brunhilde Verrier, and I work as a research fellow at the UCL Energy Institute in London. My role at EDRIC is looking specifically at the interconnection between industry's strategies and the wider social, political, and economic landscape, and how those different strategies could shape transitions in a different way. Knowing that we must, of course, accelerate the transition to net zero. Ideally, we want everyone to support the transition and to feel involved in the transition. At the very beginning of my career, I lacked role models. There were not enough of them. I felt I was one of a few girls in my area, so I felt a bit like I was the imposter. The imposter syndrome, you feel like everyone around you is absolutely comfortable in their roles and they are great, and you feel like, oh, but me, I'm absolutely not wonderful. What am I doing here? And this is something that we need just to learn, that it's not the end. It's normal to feel a bit of it, but it is all right to move ahead and to have confidence in yourself, because really everyone has something to bring to the table, absolutely everyone. What was the main influences in making you choose this specific area of science? I was very lucky that I had that light bulb moment. I knew I wanted to do something a bit more technical when I first took a flight when I was 17. It was really a moment where I was impressed by the power of the engine, by that roaring sound, and by the fact that it took me to the sky. So I decided that, okay, I want to know more about how things actually work. I want to know more about electricity, about engineering. And so I actually started a 2 years university course. I didn't succeed immediately at all. And it was also very hard because I was one of about 4 girls, I think, in a cohort of about 60 to 80 persons. Not everything was wonderful, but that was the first stepping stone. And then I had a big privilege to travel, and I went to work for 2 years in Australia for my postdoc. I worked in the corporate social responsibility in the mining industry. It opened new doors because I learned about indigenous people. I mean, it was just very, very important, a mind-opening. My background was a bit difficult. So I had a few family troubles, and I think it created the fact that my teenage years were probably even more rebellious than they should have. It's hard for everyone, but yes, for many of us, it can have that extra layer where you're really lost and you don't know where to go. Maybe if I have a message to pass on there is that it will pass and it will get better and it will continue to get better over time. You will grow out of it and you will get just more comfortable over time. So that is really something, yeah. So I didn't know that and now I know it. So yeah, I guess it would have been nice to be aware of that earlier. Young people have a big role to play. In fact, young people have been also influential very much to change things lately. We don't necessarily need always to have role models that are older than us. It's absolutely all right to have role models that are younger than us as well. My hopes for the future are really that, yes, we will be able to create fast enough, but in the right way, a society where everyone will move together toward that decarbonization and transition goal.